Okay, can we get real here? Look, it's sad the guy said, I'm truly sorry for that. But we've got to admit that what happened today wasn't part of his own fault.
How dare you talk that way?
You said we should talk.
Yes, about your feelings towards each other and the animosity you clearly hold on to. It's not drag a good man's name through the dirt.
Animosity? You mean fucking rage. The kids at this school hate each other. I mean, come on, we all feel it. This thing that's bubbling under the surface. Was it ever addressed though? No. The faculty of this school, especially him, were more concerned with outside appearances. Buying gym equipment, deck out the football team, send the cheerleaders to national competitions.
Buying metal detectors.
And what fucking use have they done? That doesn't eliminate the real problem. You can't buy hard work. The kind of hard work it takes to stop people like that feeling like they had no options left.
No amount of hard work was ever going to fix a psychopath.
He wasn't a psychopath. He was a 17-year-old kid.
They just shut up a fucking school. Why do I get the feeling that you know more than you're telling us?
Back up. I'm saying there's more to it.
Sounds to me like you're ready to write a book for the guy. What? Who is he? Your boyfriend?
Fuck you.
If you know something then...
Oh, are you as well?
Look, no one in here is going to judge you, Jason. But if you know something, we need answers.
This is ridiculous.
Go on, then.
Tell us.
Tell us.
What?
Enough! This is not the way to go about this. Look, yes, you're all free to speak your mind in this room. But that doesn't mean that you can force people to speak if they don't feel comfortable with doing so. Now, Jason will talk. When he wants to talk, it's his choice.
And you? Max, I mean.
What do you mean, you know, with your friends?
We grew up on the same street. But we were pretty close. He was a normal kid. Happy. Fun. And I thought he was cool. We hung around for years until we started high school. That's when our friendship changed. People didn't really see Max around, did? He liked all the clubs, you know, math club, science fair, and he always won the spelling bee. I guess that's just not cool enough for guys like you. People would laugh at him and make fun. I never really understood why. I mean, yeah, he was clever and a bit of a geek, but there was so much more to him. It wasn't long before the nasty remarks turned to violence. And I was starting to fall victim too. I got scared. I didn't want the next 7 years of my life to be like that. So I started to keep my distance. It was strange practically ignoring him. If I didn't just pass by, I would have been targeted too.
Coward.
That's easy for you to say. You never take an ass kick from the jerks here. Anyway, I did stay friends with him. Just outside the school. It was kind of strange at the beginning, but I think he understood. He never called me on it. He just went on like nothing had changed. Pretty cool, see?
Well, if he was so cool, why'd you shoot at the fucking school?
Because there's only so much shit one person could take before they eventually snap.
Oh, bullshit! The kid was a fucking psycho. No normal person would just wake up one day and just decide to go, why not? Oh, he's going to kill his friend.
Look, I'm not saying he didn't have issues, but he wasn't a born killer. Forget it. You'll never understand.
Then try, Jason. Try to help them understand what you mean.
Max really tried. Just to keep his head down, you know? Try to make friends. But people just didn't want to know. Eventually, he sort of withdrew. I tried to keep a friendship, but it became so hard. He only ever really spoke to me online.
So what, I'm meant to feel sorry for him now?